Hello, I'm Jashykins, and this is my first ever best of video. Now what these do are record the best song, book, whatever of each year, such as this is best of 2011, because hey, it's 2011. And this is my first year doing this, so the categories will probably change over the years. Who knows? They changed from the Oscars. Anyways, the categories this year are Best Movie, Best Book, Best Song, and Best Season of a Show. And when I get to each category, I will explain one, how the books, movies, etc. were nominated, and then I will list the nominations, and finally I will say which wins that category. So let's start. Wait, before I do, this is a personal list, so if you have any problems about it, too bad.
It is your destiny.
Fuck my destiny. Your love can change. You're the only one who matters, and the only one for me. Now I'm lonelier than ever. Only your love can save me.
First category that will be looked at today is Best Movie of 2011. Now, in order for me to nominate any of the movies, they had to meet two criteria. One, they must be a movie I have just seen for the first time this year. Second, it doesn't have to have been released this year, this since I usually don't see most movies the year that they are released anyway. And here are the nominations. Paranoia, The Writer's Cut, released in 2011. Horrible Bosses, released in 2011. A Very Harold and Kumar 3D Christmas, released in 2011. Limitless, released in 2011. Repo, The Genetic Opera, released in 2008. And finally, Black Swan, released in 2010. Now what I must say is Black Swan is a fucking awesome movie. It should have won Best Picture at the Oscars this year. That or Inception. It didn't win the Oscar, and it's not going to win my Best Movie of 2011, which they could probably give less than a fuck about. And the winner is Paranoia, The Writer's Cut. Now this is an indie film. It's very low budget. The effects aren't that great. The acting is mediocre, but it's just awesome. The story, the foreshadowing, the twist at the end. It's just great. It is awesome. And The Writer's Cut of Paranoia is available free online at www.thecinemasnob.com. And there's also the Director's Cut, which was released first, that you have to pay for, and it's on DVD. So congratulations to Paranoia, The Writer's Cut. There were only two nominations for the Best Book of 2011, and these two nominations were chosen by these three criteria. One, it must have been a book I only read for the first time this year. Two, it can't be one I started last year and finished this year, this because I might have started a book in late December of last year. And finally, only one book from a series can be chosen, but that last one was because I read a shit ton of the Dresden Files books this year, and so of course I couldn't nominate every single one. So yeah, and the two nominations for Best Book of 2011 are The Dresden Files Ghost Story by Jim Butcher, and it was released in 2011, and the other one is Full Dark No Stars by Stephen King, released in 2010. And well, they're both great authors. Well, Stephen King is a great author, and The Dresden Files is a great series. So the winner is The Dresden Files Ghost Story by Jim Butcher. And The Dresden Files, as I said before, is a series I just really adore and love. And the fact is, Ghost Story, among all the other Dresden Files books I read this year, was a real game changer for the series. Now yes, in every book of the Dresden Files, things are shown that you didn't guess before, there were new plots, blah blah blah. But Ghost Story is the first one I read that really, it just turned the whole Dresden Files universe upside down. It was that awesome. So congratulations to the Dresden Files Ghost Story by Jim Butcher for winning my Best Book of 2011. The next category is Best Song of 2011. Now, I nominated these songs based on two criteria. One, they must be a song I have heard for the first time this year, and two, only one song per artist, and I didn't have to mention that they don't have been made this year. Anyways, the nominations for the Best Song of 2011 are If I Die Young by the band Perry, Believe by the Bravery, Save Me by My Darkest Days, Undisclosed Desires by Muse, and When You're Gone, music by Akira Yamaoka, and vocals by Mary Elizabeth Glynn. And this song can be found on the Silent Hill Shattered Memories original soundtrack. Now, I know not all of these would be considered quote-unquote good songs, but these are the best ones that I could remember that I definitely heard this year. And the winner for the Best Song of 2011 is Save Me by My Darkest Days. The reason I chose this one out of the others is the fact that, I don't know, I seem to connect with this song a little bit about how the singer just wants this one girl, and the one girl's love is the only thing that can save him. It's a little desperate, but I like that, actually. So congratulations to Save Me by My Darkest Day for being the best song of 2011. And the final category is the best season of a show of 2011. And the seasons I chose were based on three criteria. One, it has to be a season from this year. You can't have nominations for multiple seasons of a show, and doesn't have to be a whole season, though it has to be a complete first or second half of a season. And the two nominations for this category are The Walking Dead, the first part of season 2, and Fringe, the first part of season 4. Now, The Walking Dead and Fringe are two shows I am just in love with. I just love them. So I had to choose between these two. And I ended up choosing for the best season of a show of 2011, The Walking Dead, the first part of season 2. Just because Fringe is awesome, but for anyone who's watched the first part of season 4 Fringe, you can understand my point. For The Walking Dead, the first part of season 2, it's the best because it takes the characters and involves them. And while this season was very much low, lacking zombies, and people felt it really dipped into the soap opera genre, the fact is, if it had not taken as long and as in detail for the characters, the ending would not have meant as much. So, it's just a great season, and I can't wait until the second part of season 2 begins, because by the end of season 2, part 1, it just seemed to be very much that there's going to be a lot of action when The Walking Dead returns.
Well, that's what I thought was the best of 2011. So congratulations again to the best movie, Paranoia, the Writer's Cut, which was an indie film. Better than any Hollywood blockbuster I have seen this year. And congratulations to the best book, The Dresden Files Ghost Story by Jim Butcher. Fucking awesome, man. Keep up the good work, Butcher. And congratulations to the best song, Save Me by My Darkest Days. just awesome. That's all I can say. It's fucking awesome. And finally, congratulations to best season of a show, The Walking Dead, the first part of season 2. Awesome. So, if you have listened to this list and disagreed with what I picked, fire away. Tell me why you disagree. Hell, even give me your own lists. But be respectful. For those of you viewing this on YouTube, it's YouTube. What can I say? But anyways, thank you for watching, and until next video, goodbye.